Trax has been around technically since 1975 over on Ogden Street. Moved here in 1977, and then we took it over, my family, in 1978. I've always been kind of environmentally minded. I ride a bike to work every day. Still don't own a car. I knew that we needed to upgrade our systems at the store, so I started looking into what that would be, and I got interested in heat pumps, and then just kind of naturally, I knew the rebates were available, and it evolved into a project that's now going to include heat pumps, solar, electrical upgrades to the store to handle the new systems.
In 2021, the City Council passed an ordinance known as the Energize Denver Ordinance to help Denver meet its climate goals through energy efficiency requirements in all buildings 5,000 square feet and larger. And that's about 11,000 buildings in the city and county of Denver. I work specifically with buildings on the smaller end of that spectrum, 5,000 to 25,000 square feet. We really try to provide a lot of flexibility for building owners in terms of how they go about meeting these requirements. We want them to make upgrades and improvements to their building in a way that works for them, that helps their bottom line, that reduces their energy bills, that makes their buildings more comfortable, makes them more attractive to clients and tenants, etc. And so one of the ways that we try to provide support and flexibility to those smaller building owners is through our Energize Denver Energy Navigation, or EDEN program. The program is open to multifamily building owners, nonprofits, and small businesses. And we basically provide coaching through the entire process of bringing their building into compliance with those energy efficiency requirements. And we also provide small grants to them also to help offset the cost of those investments. So we help them look at what that would mean for their cash flow. We do a cost-benefit analysis for them. What's this gonna mean for their bottom line? How can they best reduce their monthly energy bills? What's the payback period on these investments? Wax Trax Records was one of our first applicants to the program, and we were really excited to work with them. They're a really interesting building in that they're really making a whole host of improvements, and we were able to help them through that.
What we've already done is the LED retrofit. So we took all our fluorescent lights and put in new LED bulbs. That was actually pretty affordable. We also took one of our interior signs, which is like a old school 1950s blinking light type of sign, and retrofitted that with LEDs, and it looks awesome.
We're working with them to help them get financing through quite innovative financing mechanism here in the state of Colorado, specifically for energy-related upgrades to buildings. CPACE is a loan that is repaid as a special assessment on your property taxes, and that's how you pay back that loan. But if you sell the building, that assessment stays with the building, so it transfers to the new owner. So some people are hesitant to make investments in their building that might require like a 20-year payback because they're not confident that they're going to be there for that 20 years. That kind of gives people a little more confidence that they can make those investments in their building.
But what is exciting is that we'll be able to run our strap with very little cost in the future. And I look towards the next generations of ownership of Wax Trax because everybody in the city tells me they never want it to go away. So my son Otto, I don't want him to have a lot of expenses, so it's better to be independent.
We help them figure out what they qualify for, we help them get the right paperwork in, we help them capture all those rebates and incentives that they possibly can. That's how we really approach this program. What problems do you have that we can help you solve, right?
So one of the challenges with this project in our store is that we're trying to preserve this space, which has been the same for 47 years. These posters up here has been there since 1977 or 1978. So, and there's lots of stuff like that all over the store. So you need to have a solid design so that the contractors come in and they know what to avoid messing with. I'm really focused on taking the new through the lens of the old. So, you know, this store has been around since 1978. I envision Wax Trax being in more places, but also preserving this center, the headquarters of Wax Trax forever.